Hello friends, today I will tell you the basic logic and method of modding. If you want to continue, don't forget to like the video and write a comment. The information contained in this presentation is for educational purposes only. The content of the presentation describes the modification of game files, and such operations are generally prohibited by game developers. The purpose of the presentation is to share technical information, and no responsibility is accepted for the consequences of illegal or unethical use. So remember that all responsibility lies with you. Game modding is changing the content or codes of a game. Modding can be used to gain an in-game advantage or to personalize the gaming experience, which can also fall into the category of cheating. The steps we will do are as follows. We will decompile a game. We will search its libraries. We will find the dump file of the game. The dump file means the source files of the game. We will search the dump. We will find and change the necessary offsets. When you sign your game, all the processes are complete. So what do we need to install, you ask? These are the applications we will use for these operations. To do these operations, you need a device or emulator, an application that can parse APKs, such as MT Manager or NT Manager. If you are using a computer, you can also use the Easy APK tool. We will use Notepad++ to make searches in the dump file easier. It is a good choice for examining HXD binary files, that is, files ending in .so. These are all the apps you need for modding, you won't need anything else. Now let me tell you a little about APK files. APK files are generally divided into two, as Unity and non-Unity. We will use IDA Pro to dump non-Unity files, but now is not the time for that. For now, just focus on learning, don't try to do anything. If there is enough interest, I will explain the video in a practical way. Anyway, in Unity we will use libuild2cpp. In non-Unity, it will usually be libuild2cocos, but this can always change. I will explain its logic. Just keep these two types in mind. APK libraries are also divided into 32-bit and 64-bit. You will go to the file you want to cheat on which bit. It is very simple. Common data types are divided into four. These are the most common. In is used to hold in-game numeric values, points, health, etc. Dward represents 32-bit integers. It is one of the performance critical data types. Double is often used for precise calculations. Boolean values are 1 or 0, yes or no. For example, a yes or no answer to the question, should spending be active? I may have filled your mind all at once. Don't worry, I will explain it with an example in a moment. Our first step is to decompile the APK. For this, we can get help from MT Manager or NT Manager. This parses the source files of the game and allows us to see inside the APK. The inside of the file usually looks like this. Step 2 is to find the necessary library. We just entered the lib file. These two options came to us. If we want it in 32-bit, we will enter V7A. If we want it in 64-bit, we will enter V8A. Step 3 is to get the dump file from the APK. The way to do this is to change the name of the libuild2cpp file to librealunity, and then put the libuild2cpp in the fake lib application into your file. After doing this, you will be able to see the dump file of your game after running the game once. Step 4 is to examine the dump file thoroughly. We will do this using Notepad++. We can find many values at the same time. For example, if you are looking for the gold value in the game, you can search for things like cash, money, gold in the file. For example, in the example shown here, we have a double and get average jackpot gold value. We want to test whether this value will work in the game. First, we need to get the offset of this value. The RVA value is the offset. The RVA above our value is the offset of that value. Let's copy this value. Step 5 is to change the necessary offsets. I just told you that we copied the offset. We are entering the application's libuild2cpp. So file with our HXD application. HXD is a binary solver. When libuild2cpp solves so, it will turn into millions of numbers like this. Here we will go to the search section, where we can enter the offset by pressing Ctrl+G. we will paste the offset we just copied without the 0 and x at the beginning. For example, we will start with 17,744 for the previous value. When we search for the value, it will take us to the offset itself. The simple logic of binary is that values are in binary form. We will generally use 8-digit pairs for values such as double, DORed, or Boolean. In other words, we will change 16 numbers side by side to change a value. If you ask what I need to paste, I will share the determined hex codes and the hex codes with known direct values in another video if there is enough interest, or you can just search on the internet. These codes can also be found in pairs of 10 or 12. I will explain the logic of this later. We will generally use the 8-digit one. After reaching the offset we specified, we will paste the new value we need to paste with Ctrl plus B. It should look like this after pasting. You can then exit after saving the file by pressing Ctrl plus S. Sixth and final step, now we need to sign the APK. Signing the APK is important because most APK will not work without signing. In this example, when you hold down the APK in MT Manager, the function of the Sign APK button is, now all we have to do is enter the game and test our APK. Congratulations, your game is ready now. Here I tried to explain the logic of game modding in the simplest way. With the information here, you can mod simple games by trying. No one can become a modder in 8 minutes. The purpose of this video was to explain the basics of modding. If there's enough interest, we will mod some games in practice. In this way, you will understand much better. If you have any questions or suggestions, please don't forget to mention them in the Discord or comments. By the way, we have activated the join button. It will be really useful for those who want to support. Thank you very much for watching. Take care of yourself and see you soon.